Hello, and welcome to the FireVoxel tutorials. In this tutorial, we will show you how to use FireVoxel to adjust the grayscale window, select the color maps, use the zoom tools, view images in different orthogonal planes, and customize the user interface. If you want to follow along, please download sample data from our website and extract them onto your hard drive. First, let's import a set of DICOM images. Here, we have a list of abdominal CT images. Let's click Load. Next, we'll confirm the value conversion from the CT Hounsfield units to grayscale values. This linear transformation has the slope of 1 and the intercept of 1024. With this choice, air, which shows on CT as -1024 Hounsfield units, will correspond to 0 signal, and water, which is 0 Hounsfield units on CT, will show as +1024. Let's click OK. And here are our abdominal images. Let's save them as a FireVoxel document. Now let's select a slice through the lungs and double right-click to view it. Next, let's adjust the grayscale window for optimal viewing of different tissues. We can do this by using the Change Width and Level tool on the main toolbar. Click the icon with a black and white circle, and the cursor also becomes a circle. To increase the window width, left-click on the image, hold down the mouse button, and drag the mouse horizontally towards the right. To decrease the width, drag the mouse towards the left. To raise the window center, click and drag the mouse upwards. To lower the center, drag the mouse downwards. For the lungs, we need a wide window and a low level. For the bone, we also need a wider window but a higher level. When you are using this tool, you can scroll through the slices. Let's select a slice through the abdomen and adjust the window for soft tissue. This will require a lower level and a narrow width. When you are done, press Escape key on your keyboard to exit from this tool. You can also adjust the grayscale window or select a color map by adjusting the layer properties. Let's double-click on the image to bring up the layer control panel. Here we see our images in the active layer. And now, let's click View Filter. This brings up a panel with the grayscale and color map options. Right now, our image is in grayscale, and therefore the color map option is none. If we want to display our image as a color map, we can select an appropriate map by clicking one of these radio buttons. Here on the left is the grayscale color bar. The window width and center are also shown in these boxes on the lower right. We can adjust the width and center by typing in values or using the up and down buttons. If we want to undo these changes, we can click Default. Right now, higher signal intensity values are shown as lighter gray levels. If you want to show higher values as darker shades, click Invert Scale. And when you're done, click OK. Now let's readjust the window and explore FireVoxel's zoom tools. They are available either through the View menu or through the main toolbar. The first option is Zoom by Window. It allows us to select and magnify a rectangular portion of the image. Activate this tool by clicking the toolbar icon with a magnifying glass. Now, let's click on the image and drag the mouse over the part that we want to enlarge and then release the mouse. To unzoom or restore the original view, use Zoom All by clicking this icon with 4 arrows. The next pair of tools is Zoom In and Zoom Out that magnify or shrink the entire image. The last option is Zoom 1:1. It's available through the View menu and allows you to display each image voxel as one screen pixel. Again, to restore the original view, click Zoom All. Note that by default, images are displayed with interpolation. To change the interpolation options, go to File, User Interface Options, Display with Interpolation. If you uncheck the box for volumes, your images will be shown without interpolation and will appear more pixelated. Often, we want to view our images not just as they were acquired, but in other orientations as well. Here we have axial images. Let's use the Display Orthogonal Projections tool on the main toolbar with the icon with X, Y, and Z axes. This will open two new document windows with the coronal and sagittal views. The window with the original image will be labeled number 1, and the orthogonal projections will be labeled 2 and 3. Right now, the windows are tiled. We can rearrange them using View, Cascade, or we can retile them using View, Tile. If you click on one image, the current cursor position will be marked by the crosshair, and the other two views will display the orthogonal cross sections through that point, also indicated by the crosshair. You can scroll through the slices on the active window, but the other two views will only show the slices indicated by the crosshair. To turn off this functionality, go to File, User Interface Options. Here, under Volumetric Cursor, the crosshair is activated when multi-projections synchronize on left mouse click is selected. To turn it off, select Regular from the drop-down menu. Now you can scroll each view completely independently without affecting the other two views. If we want to preserve a particular custom view, we can save it as a FireVoxel document. For example, let's save this coronal view and close all windows. Now, let's reopen our saved document. And here is our coronal view as we saved it. Now, our original images were axial. What happened to these images when we switched to the coronal view? Let's save the images in this document using Save Active Layer as DICOM. Now let's close this window. And now let's reload the DICOM images that we've just saved. You can see that they are axial, exactly as they were when we first loaded them. It is important to remember that all view tools, including display orthogonal projections, do not alter the images, but only modify how the images are displayed. If you want to preserve your custom view, save your work as a FireVoxel document. Now let's explore other viewing options, such as the maximum intensity projection. Let's open a document with axial abdominal MR angiography images. And just for convenience, let's reactivate the crosshair. Now, let's click Display Orthogonal Projections to show the other views. Let's click on the original axial view and select View Maximum Intensity Projection Snapshot. And now we have here the axial maximum intensity projection. Let's save this view. Let's now do the same for the coronal view. And the sagittal view. And now we have all three maximum intensity projections for this image set. This concludes this tutorial on FireVoxel viewing options. For more information, please visit our website. Thank you.